will ban nach kan di di church patch ke maka chicks is kabilalut ki oso di kabilalut ki kawi ruma ka chinara usakaran ala uskil na kana ko ustin jo kina an poni ka hel chok chok clip chingi ko usla mana poni la an awo ni di chok chok clip ko chabil na jo ka hel ak
Inga alecropping is a new smart way of farming which brings more and healthier food crops while reducing the amount of work and money spent on a farm. In this system, Inga trees are planted in rows to improve the soil fertility, and in between the rows, the crops are grown year after year. Inga trees, locally known as bri-bri, are leguminous, meaning that they give nutrients back to the soil. The trees planted in rows grow until they create a canopy that shades the alleys in between, which kills weeds. The Inga trees are pruned, the leaves left on the ground for mulch and the branches used for firewood to use or sell. Annual crops are then planted in between the rows without the need for fertilizers or herbicides. The Inga alecropping system can be used to grow a wide variety of crops, food for your family, and crops to sell for cash. Because the Inga trees increase the richness of the soil, ears of corn that are grown in an Inga plot often look healthier and are larger. Additionally, when chemicals are not used, it means the food is healthier for your family to eat. If your farmland is grassy, planting Inga trees in rows will get rid of the grass and restore the health of the plot. Because Inga plots can be used for up to 20 years, you won't need to use fires and worry about causing damage to your neighbor's farms. At the same time, you are helping to save forests. Inga trees are very good at holding soil in place and have been used on slopes to prevent erosion. Additionally, they deter certain pests from destroying your crops. The Inga alecropping system requires very little labor to maintain after it has been established. At Yashe, we recommend using the Inga edulis species because it produces a lot of big leaves, which are good for mulch. The trees also have a quick rate of recovery after pruning and a high number of nodules on their roots that release nutrients into the soil. Here are the steps you should follow to establish an Inga alecropping plot on your farm. First, obtain your Inga seeds, which reach peak availability during the months of April and October. You will need 2,000 seeds for a 1-acre farm plot. If obtaining pods, do not store the seeds in the pods or they will rot. Once you get the seeds, make sure to keep them damp in moist sados, but not longer than 48 hours. Don't use mud to keep your seeds moist, as they will begin to rot. You can plant Inga directly in the ground or grow the seedlings in a nursery and transplant them. Direct planting is less labor intensive, but you can lose 20 to 25% of your plants. On the other hand, planting the seeds in bags in a nursery has a higher survival rate. The plants in the nursery would need watering, weeding, transporting, and transplanting. Either way, you will have a higher survival rate if you plant during rainy season. If you choose to establish a nursery, make sure to position it near a source of water with natural shade if possible. If there is no shade, you can use kuhun leaves or shade cloth. The size of the nursery should be about 120 square feet, which will allow for 5 rows of seedlings, each row being 3 bags wide by 167 bags long. Fill your 4-inch by 10-inch nursery bags with topsoil. Then place the seeds 1 inch deep with the side of the seed containing the cross-shaped indentation facing downward. If planting during the dry season, you will need to water your seeds every 2 days. How you establish your plot will depend on whether your farm is on flat land or on a slope. If you are using flat land and your land is cleared, you can proceed from there. But if it isn't cleared yet, you only need to clear where the rows will go after your peg. You should orient your rows from east to west so that your annual crops will get plenty of sun. Set up the stakes, marking the edge of your rows either 12 or 15 feet apart. Then use a string as a guide to establish the rows. If you are planting on a slope, you will need to build an A-frame. Get two pieces of stick or lumber strips that are 210 cm long and nail them together at 200 cm. Stake two pegs 2 meters apart. Then open the legs of the A-frame and stand them on the pegs. Nail a piece of stick or lumber strip that is 110 cm long at the 1 meter mark on each leg. Hang a heavy object from a string tied at the apex of the A-frame. With the A-frame standing, allow the string to hit the cross piece until it hits the same place 3 times, then mark the location. Turn the A-frame 180 degrees and repeat the process. Measure the distance between the points marked, divide by 2 and mark the midpoint with a pen or create a groove. If you are establishing your plot on a slope, you will need to start with a cleared area. You will first establish a baseline. Assess your slope, looking for steep inclines and depressions. Toward the middle of the plot, establish your baseline from the top of the slope to the bottom in the area with the fewest dips, bumps, and rocky outcroppings. Every 4 meters going downhill, place a stake using your A-frame to measure. Ensure the stakes are aligned in a straight line. Next, you will establish your contour. On one side of the baseline, use the A-frame to find the point 2 meters away that is level with the stake. The hanging object should be aligned with the midpoint. Peg the point. Repeat this process to the edge of the plot and repeat on the other side of the baseline. Adjust the pegs by moving up to 3 out of every 10 so that the line has a natural curve. Repeat these steps for each stake in the baseline. Whether planting on flat land or a slope, you are now ready to transplant your seedlings. Prepare the row by clearing away the mulch. Use a measuring stick to place stakes 18 inches apart on the rows. Dig holes 6 to 10 inches deep, depending on the depth of the soil in the bag. The plant root should not be exposed but level with the surface. Place the topsoil to one side as you dig the hole and then place the topsoil back into the bottom of the hole. Cut the most bottom part of the plastic bags in which the seedlings are located. Place the seedlings in the holes and slide the bags up and over the top of the seedling to remove them. Collect your plastic bags and properly dispose of them. Ensure that you maintain your plot following the farm calendar. You can take advantage of the time when the Inga is growing by planting a crop in the alleys. If it's rainy season, you can plant okra in between the rows. If it's dry season, you can plant peppers, beans, or corn. The time of the year will affect your maintenance. clean weeds and vines around the plants during the rainy season for the first 6 months to a year. The next step is to prune your Inga. This will take place after 18 to 24 months when the trees have formed a canopy over the alleys. When you prune will depend on what and when you are planting. You can plant 3 days after pruning. Prune the trees to chest height, cutting the branches at a 45 degrees angle with a sharp machete. Do not use a chainsaw. Leave the leaves and small branches finely chopped on the ground for mulch and use the thicker branches for firewood. You are now ready to plant your annual crop. For corn, leave 60 cm between the Inga row and the first row of corn on each side. Evenly space 4 rows of corn in between the Inga rows. As your crop grows, cut the fast growing, low growing Inga shoots that are coming over toward the crop. We recommend ultimately establishing 3 plots of Inga and rotating between them. The plots can be used for 20 years until the Inga trees stop growing back as quickly because of multiple pruning. At this point, you can remove the old trees and plant new Inga. You now have an Inga alicropping system that you can use to provide food for your family, earn income, and contribute to reforestation.